Good afternoon and welcome to the grand opening of our beautiful Romeoville campus expansion. It's hard to believe that it has been 2 years since we celebrated the start of this project. Today's celebration marks the conclusion of several years of planning to further develop our presence in the village of Romeoville, and we offer increased educational opportunities to the surrounding communities. We opened our first campus on this site in 1993, and today's event is truly a reaffirmation of our commitment to teaching and learning and to continuing our strong partnerships with the village. Many of you have contributed in some way to this project, and we're glad you're here to celebrate. I see alumni board members, foundation board members, members of our architecture team, and our contractors for this project, and we thank all of you. This expansion adds more than 49,000 square feet to the campus and provides a new and enhanced amenity for students, including enrollment services, counseling space, financial aid, testing and tutoring, and a campus bookstore on site, our updated cafeteria, science labs, disability services, career services, and student activities. In this lobby space we are standing in now provides a place for students and visitors to congregate, something we did not have in the existing campus space, which we've also renovated as part of this project. But beyond the features of this beautiful and modernized facility, this expansion allows us to grow our services to better support you and our community. We know our students have so many responsibilities between work, family, and their education, and so offering courses and programs that fit their busy lives is integral in our planning. The expansion of this campus allows us to offer a wider variety of courses in primetime hours, as well as early evening courses and accelerated courses. Students are now able to complete a full Associate of Science degree entirely at the Romeoville campus without coming back to main campus. Opportunities also exist to complete an Associate of Arts degree at the expanded campus, a transfer degree for many majors including business, psychology, social work, pre-law, and others. Another new feature is the high-tech collaborative classroom. It is designed to allow students to engage in technology-centered collaborative learning with instructors and fellow students. So whether students want to train to enter directly into the workforce or a clear pathway to transfer and complete their bachelor's degree, JJC offers all of these opportunities. Before we move into the rest of the program, allow me to briefly introduce the elected officials who have joined in our celebration today and who are all integral to the continued success of our institution. We have Carl Gilmore, president of the Plainfield Public Library District. Mayor, we'll hold our applause till the end. Mayor John Noak of Romeoville, Jennifer Bertino Tarrant, Senator of the 49th District, Anastasia Tusky for Will County Executive Larry Walsh, Pat McGuire, State Senator District 43, Bob Jaskowitz, Village Trustee Bolingbrook, David Welter, State Representative 75th District, Natalie Manley, State Representative 98th District, and Lou Aguirre, Romeoville Trustee. Thank you all for attending. Next, I would like to introduce our JJC Board of Trustees that are here this evening. First, we have Chairman Bob Wunderlich. We have Trustee Dan O'Connell, Trustee Mike O'Connell, Trustee Alicia Morales, and Trustee Jake Mahalik. Thank you. On that note, I'm pleased to introduce JJC Board Chairman Bob Wunderlich. Chairman Wunderlich has served our district for 40 years. It's truly amazing. He is one of only a handful of college trustees across the state who have served their campus communities for that length of time. He has been a major advocate of modernizing our campus infrastructure for the last 10 years, and we're lucky to have his background and expertise throughout this endeavor. With that, please join me in welcoming Chairman Robert Wunderlich.
Thank you, Dr. Mitchell, and welcome everybody who came out with us this evening, this afternoon, and I hope the rain holds off for you. As I was walking in from the parking lot with Mayor John Noak, I mentioned it just seems like yesterday that we were out here with the groundbreaking, with the hard hats and the shovels, and look what we have today. And thank you, DKA. As a board, we've invested a good deal of our time, money, and resources to develop the physical blueprint of our campus network, especially over the last 10 years. As trustees, it is our role to develop the future vision for our college. I believe that over these years, we have truly changed the entire landscape of the college. We have supported the development of new campus spaces that make higher education accessible and provide the courses and programs that you need in your community. The village of Romeoville has been over the last 20 years an incredible partner in this undertaking. It was our vision to evolve our facilities, to innovate in academics, and to serve the broad base of individuals living in this community, from traditional age students to returning adult students and so many more. This facility allows us to expand educational opportunity to you, our current students, and to our prospective students, and to strengthen relationships with the village and other educational partners in the area. To us, it's about teamwork and how we collectively work together to better serve our students and support their success. Thank you again to our partners at the village. We couldn't be here today without your constant collaboration. Thank you very much.
Now, I'm pleased to introduce Dominic DeMonica, principal at DeMonica Kemper Architects. Dominic and the team at DKA have been great partners to the college on various projects, including the design work on our beautiful City Center campus and our amazing new event center. Their expertise and guidance has been invaluable. Please join me in welcoming Dominic DeMonica to the podium.
Good afternoon, and thank you, Dr. Mitchell. It certainly is a pleasure to be here this afternoon. I'd like to first of all start by thanking the Board of Trustees, Dr. Mitchell, your entire administrative team, for allowing us the opportunity to be part of this incredible project. This is one that we are very, very proud to be part of. I also want to specifically thank the user groups, the facilities group that we met with, and really everybody and anybody that provided any input at all on this project, because it's that kind of input that really makes a project like this a success. So when we were first engaged to work with the college on this project, the primary goal was to create space to allow for growth and expansion in this part of the district. We started by providing an addition to the building, very simple addition to the existing structure, but it soon became very clear that this project could be so much more and so much greater. So that's when we started to look at a standalone building just to the west side of the existing building. As we put together a very rough framework for the long-term development of the overall campus, the idea that we could create a building that creates a new front door for the campus really was born. As you actually look at the building on Google Maps, which is kind of neat because Google Maps already has the building on it in its completed form, what you will see is a building that really consists of two separate bars. There's one that runs in the east-west direction that really faces 135th Street, and that creates the front door presence. And there's another one right here that is at a 45-degree angle. This 45-degree angle bar here actually is strategically located to aim right towards Village Hall, strengthening and highlighting the relationship between the village and the college. You'll also notice on this particular part of the building that the roof line rises up as it moves that direction. So there's some symbology in the building in terms of the way that the overall building is situated. Combined with the original building here on campus, this new structure, which is, as Dr. Mitchell said, just under 50,000 square feet, actually creates a true campus here in Romeoville. Student services spaces that exist here on the first floor include a new welcome desk, admissions and registration, financial aid, counseling, tutoring, and a testing center. All of these functions have actually been modeled after those similar functions on the main campus, so there's some continuity for students as they go from campus location to campus location. Student life space includes this large, flexible, multi-purpose room over here to be used for students, to be used by the community for various events, food service to my left, and you'll also see behind me a 150-seat dining space that has incredible views, and now with the new soccer fields coming in, you can sit and watch games when the weather's not so great. And we've got an outdoor dining space that'll actually flow directly onto as well. Turning to the second floor, that's really where all the formal learning spaces are. Classrooms and the labs, computer labs and science labs that Dr. Mitchell spoke about. The other thing that's important to note when you walk around this building are the very liberal sprinkling of student life space that exists. You'll see opportunities for students to gather with faculty, for staff to get together and collaborate in a much more informal space, really making this, again, that true campus environment. And lastly, continuing the college's commitment to sustainability, I'm going to point out a few things that were done in the design of this facility. First of all, this building uses 30% less water than a typical building of this type based on a baseline building. Through our energy conscious design, we were also able to design a building that uses approximately 20% less energy than a similar building type. And to offset the energy that is used by the building, there's a photovoltaic array up on the roof that you might see when you get really far back from the building. And that offsets about 9% of the total energy usage of the building. So again, a strong commitment to sustainability by the college. As I said earlier, we're extremely proud to be part of this project. We think it turned out really well. We hope that it serves the students and the community of Joliet Junior College well into the future. Thank you.
It's now my pleasure to introduce Mayor John Noak. Mayor Noak and the Village of Romeoville have been exceptional partners throughout the development of this project. Mayor Noak understands the power of education and its singular ability to change lives. He is a true ambassador for JJC. Mayor Noak's background includes over 20 years working with local, state, and federal governments. He was elected to a second four-year term serving the Village of Romeoville in 2013. Before that, he served as the Romeoville Village Trustee from 2005 to 2009. Prior to his service to the Village of Romeoville, Mayor Noak was the Director of Community Affairs and Communications for U.S. Representative Judy Biggert. While he has worked here for more than 8 years, please join me in welcoming Mayor John Noak.
Thank you very much, and let me tell you how exciting it is to be here today. You know, a lot of kind words from everybody involved in this project, but I think really, on behalf of the Village of Romeoville, we want to thank you, because really this partnership, we're very fortunate in Romeoville that has some great partnerships, but one of the biggest and most longstanding and most important ones is with Joliet Junior College. So I want to thank Dr. Mitchell, I want to thank the entire board, I want to thank the entire Joliet Junior College community for everything it does for Romeoville. And I look forward, you know, we talk about the groundbreaking, how quickly it went before the building was here. But you know what the reality is, I look at it today, is I look at decades to come. The students, the residents that are going to be helped by this facility, they're going to get to believe in their own futures. I see futures here as we come here today. And that's exciting. And think about all that time ahead that this facility is going to provide. And it, you know, I'm going to thank you on a personal note because you can give us a great view from Village Hall, as you mentioned. And it really is. You look at the architecture here, you look at our village hall, you look at everything around us, and why this site is so important. It just kind of hearts within the community, within Romeoville. And how welcoming this campus is, along with the other sites, the parks, the trails, it really is something special where people can come and learn, they can communicate, they can be a part of culture and celebrate each other, and businesses can come and be a part of our communities. And it really is not just our community, it's the region. I'm fortunate to work with many of my colleagues on a regular basis. And this campus provides such an important asset for every community in this area, especially in Northern Will County. It's so vital to our economic development, to the fostering and growth of our own residents. So thank you. Thank you on so many different levels for continuing to invest in this area, to invest in this campus, and really bring us top quality opportunities for our residents. So I'm just glad to be here. We're fortunate to be partners with you. So thank you once again.
Speaking on behalf of our students today is Daisy Alcantar, a 2013 JJC graduate. Daisy said she made JJC her first choice because it was affordable, close to home, and most of all because she knew immediately how dedicated the faculty and staff were to their students. Daisy is currently studying at Northern Illinois University, seeking a Master's of Accountancy. After graduation, she plans to pursue a career at PricewaterhouseCoopers. Please join me in welcoming Daisy to the podium.
Hello, everyone. Thank you for that warm welcoming. As mentioned earlier, my name is Daisy Alcantar, and today I come to represent one of the many voices of the students who have graduated from Joliet Junior College. I am delighted to be here today at the grand opening of the campus expansion. Now more than ever, it is fundamental that students have access to higher education. As a graduate business student, I have often found that investing in education gives us our best return on investment. It is the key to unlocking countless doors that are often not open to many of our students who do not have access to higher learning institutions. To put it simply, education is transformational, education is power, and education does change lives. Nelson Mandela once said, "Education is the most powerful tool that can be used to change the world." While I am only one person, and I may not be able to change the world by myself, but I believe that by coming together, we can start to make a better change. Romeoville is immersed with diversity, supportive citizens, and it will be the backbone of this campus. As a first-generation student myself, I grew up near the area with my mother, who raised me with a vision to excel in school. She herself had never gone to college, nor high school, or even elementary school. And now I'm doing my graduate Master's of Accountancy, which I will be graduating in May. Looking ahead, I believe that the underlying foundation of education lies in building character, scholarship, compassion, and perseverance. Having access to education is not simply about studying to get a better job or to get a good degree. Instead, it is how we will use our education to change our perspective in life, how we will engage in conversations, and how we will learn to respect one another even when our viewpoints are not the same. During my 2 years at JJC, I was given access to many opportunities that allowed me to engage in powerful conversations, leadership workshops, and to gain valuable lessons both inside and outside the classroom. Pam Dilday, who serves as the Director for Student Activities and Student Life, once mentored me when I was here. She was always very busy, but she always made time for her students. When I was a student here, I changed my major like 5 times. But she was always here to listen and always was very supportive. She encouraged me to attain a leadership role in student government. And the semester following, I also ran for vice president of Sigma Delta Mu, which is the foreign language honor society on campus. These opportunities allowed me to gain a full ride scholarship at Northern Illinois University when I transferred from here. I share this story because my story is very similar to those of other students here. We come from all walks of life, and the faculty here has always been very supportive. So I want to say thank you to you for giving us those opportunities. Overall, this expansion will have a long-lasting imprint on the community. On behalf of the students, I would like to say thank you once again for investing in us and the future generations that will come after me. Thank you.
Thank you, Daisy. It's now time for me to invite the members of the JGC Board of Trustees to join me at the ceremonial ribbon. Seated. I'm thinking we might have to decide on maybe another building at one point in time, because where else are we going to use these scissors? We can talk about that. So we've reached the conclusion of our program, and I hope you'll stay and have refreshments and visit with our faculty, staff, and students. You should have received a self-guided tour map when you arrived, which outlines several areas of interest to check out in the first and second floors of the expansion, as well as the areas that were renovated within the existing campus. We will have JJC representatives in each of these areas to greet you and talk to you about the spaces highlighted on the tour. Go at your own pace and in the order you'd like. Last but certainly not least, I would like to thank some individuals who are the unsung heroes of these building projects. This includes our Facility Services Director, Pat Van Dyne, Construction Manager, Rick Lyman, and their teams for the incredible amount of work they do behind the scenes to bring a massive project like this to life. Additionally, I'd like to thank members of the Planning Committee, Romeoville faculty and staff, Campus Police, Communications and Marketing, Facility Services, Food Services, the JJC Foundation and Resource Development, and media services for all of their great work and creativity to bring this event to us today. This concludes the formal part of our program. Thank you all for being here and your support of Joliet Junior College.